un estante para levantarme.
Some of you need to tell your face that you got the joy of the Lord inside, you know.
Algunos tienen que cambiar su rostro porque.
No, I said some of you need to tell your face that you got the joy of the Lord inside.
Algunos tienen que decirle a su rostro que tú tienes el gozo del Señor dentro
Amen.
De ti para que te sonría. Amén.
I mean, dear Lord, I mean, hey. Pastor said we got to be thankful, right? Thank God that you're breathing, that you're alive. You know, you're not in
Tienes que darle gracias a Dios que tú estás vivo, que no estás en un hospital.
Right? You got two legs and two arms.
Tienes dos pies y dos manos.
You know, sometimes I see people that have no legs and stuff. I said, thank you, Jesus, that I got two legs I can walk around, you know? Hello, we take a lot of things for granted, you know?
Tomamos muchas cosas, you know, en vano y no le damos la importancia.
Amen. So let's pray.
Vamos a orar.
Father, we thank you and praise you this morning.
Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, y te adoramos en esta mañana.
For the privilege that we have to gather together.
Por el privilegio de estar unidos.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
En el poderoso nombre de Jesús.
We thank you for your holy written word.
Te damos gracias por tu santa palabra.
Which is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path.
Que es lámpara a nuestros pies y lumbrera a nuestro camino.
And we thank you for the precious gift of the Holy Spirit.
Y te damos gracias por el precioso regalo del Espíritu Santo.
Our teacher, our guide.
Nuestro maestro, nuestro guía.
Our comforter.
Nuestro consolador.
We yield to you, Holy Spirit.
Nos rendimos a ti, Espíritu Santo.
Have your way in this service.
Haz lo que quieras hacer en el servicio.
Not our will, but your will be done.
Que no sea nuestra voluntad, pero la tuya.
And we'll be quick to give Jesus all praise, all glory.
Y somos rápidos de darle toda la gloria y toda la honra.
For all that will be done.
A Jesús de todo lo que
and
se haga.
Everybody said.
Y todo el mundo dice.
Tell somebody next to you, you're going to be blessed today.
Dile a alguien y toca a alguien, vas a ser bendecido hoy.
Amen. Real quick, I have materials that I brought with me.
Tengo material que yo traje conmigo.
In Spanish and English.
En español e inglés.
There's no music.
No hay música.
Okay, it's all teaching. Good teaching.
Todo es enseñanza, buena enseñanza.
I would encourage you to go back afterwards and avail yourself.
Y te motivo para que busques el material allá atrás.
This is a message entitled Learning How to Forgive.
Un mensaje de cómo perdonar.
A lot of people are sick today because they got unforgiveness in their heart.
Muchas personas están enfermos porque tienen falta de perdón
They're
en su
bitter.
Corazón.
They're resentful.
Están amargados, tienen resentimiento.
We have to learn how to forgive.
Tenemos que aprender
Amen.
A perdonar.
The End Time Wealth Transfer. 3 CDs.
La transferencia de las finanzas a los hijos de Dios en los últimos
yeah,
tiempos.
In this last days, God's going to take the wealth of the wicked, put it into the hands of the just.
En estos últimos tiempos, el Señor pasará de las finanzas de los impíos a los hijos de Dios.
But not just any just, the just that know what to do with money.
No todos los justos, los justos que saben qué hacer con su dinero.
And the primary reason God wants you to prosper is so that you can abound to every good work.
Y la razón que Dios quiere que tú prosperes para que tú hagas buenas obras.
No, that you can abound to every good work. In other
y que
words,
abundes
every good
en buenas obras.
So you can sow into every good ministry. That's why God wants you to prosper.
Y que puedas sembrar en muchos ministerios. Por eso quiere el Señor que tú prosperes.
Amen. See, by doing that, you're putting the kingdom of God first.
Haciendo eso, tú pones el reino de Dios primero.
And all the things you need will be added to you.
Y todas las demás cosas serán añadidas.
This is two CDs on prosperity principles.
Dos CDs en hablar de prosperidad, hablando de prosperidad.
This is 5 CDs on beware of false prophets.
5 CDs acerca de cuidado con los falsos profetas.
Every single New Testament writer, with the exception of James,
todos los que escribieron el Nuevo Testamento, excepto Santiago,
dealt with false prophets in the church.
Hablaron de falsos profetas que vienen a la iglesia.
And the Holy Spirit revealed to us through Jesus, through Peter,
el Señor nos reveló a nosotros a través de Jesús, de Pedro,
John, through Jude,
de Juan, de Judas,
that we will deal with false prophets in the land today.
Que vamos a nosotros estar bregando con falsos profetas hoy día.
And we have to learn to differentiate between that which is false and that which is true.
Y tenemos que diferenciar en aquello que es falso y aquello que es verdad.
And so I talk about all of that. I talk about the difference between the simple gift of prophecy and the ministry of the prophet.
Y yo hablo acerca del don de profecía y el ministerio de del profeta.
And so that's all available. And there's a lot of other messages out there. This is I've written a number of books that are used in Bible schools.
Y otros mensajes que tengo allá. Este libro se usa en escuelas, institutos
this
bíblicos.
This is entitled Prosperity, God's Will for You.
Prosperidad, la voluntad de Dios para tu vida.
Prayer, key to moving God.
Oración, la llave para que Dios se mueva.
Basic Bible truth every believer should know.
Los principios básicos que todo cristiano debe saber.
God's grace for victorious living. How you can grow in the favor of God.
La gracia de Dios para una vida victoriosa.
Understanding spiritual authority in the church.
Entendiendo la autoridad espiritual en la iglesia.
And the doctrine of water baptism.
Y la doctrina del bautismo en aguas.
That's all back there.
Todo está allá atrás.
Some other stuff. Oh, here we go.
Gloria a Dios.
All right.
Muy bien.
Enough of that. I want you to open your Bibles to Genesis, the first chapter.
Quiero que abran su Biblia en Génesis, el capítulo 1.
I want to talk to you this morning about how to have your needs met.
Quiero hablarte en esta mañana de cómo tú proveer tus necesidades, cómo tus necesidades deben ser provistas.
You know, God wants to meet your needs.
Dios quiere proveer tus necesidades.
But there's something that you must learn to do in order for those needs to be met.
Pero tú tienes que hacer ciertas cosas para que esas necesidades sean suplidas.
Now, when God refurbished the earth and placed the Garden of Eden,
cuando Dios recreó la tierra y hizo el jardín del Edén,
he established certain spiritual principles.
Él estableció ciertos principios espirituales.
That not only work in the spirit realm but in the natural realm.
Que no solamente trabajan en lo espiritual, pero trabajan en lo natural.
The first one is that everything would produce after its kind.
Lo primero es que todo es producido de acuerdo a su género.
In other words, trees would produce seed.
Árboles producen semillas.
That when planted will produce after its kind.
Que cuando se es plantado le producen su género.
That's found in Genesis 1, verse 11 and 12.
Eso se encuentra en Génesis 1, del verso 11 y 12.
Now it says, then God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb that yields seed, and the fruit tree that yields fruit, according to its kind, whose seed in itself, on the earth, and it was so. And the earth brought forth grass and herb that yields seed according to its kind, and the tree that yields fruit, whose seed is in itself, according to its kind, and God saw that it was good. So this is not a natural law, it is a spiritual law that also governs the natural realm.
Esto es una ley espiritual que gobierna la área natural.
You know, because in Galatians, it says in Galatians 6:7, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
En Gálatas 6:7 dice que lo que el hombre siembra, eso va a cosechar.
You know, in the book of Job,
en el libro de Job,
the fourth chapter,
el capítulo 4,
it says this. I want you to see that this is also a spiritual law, not just a natural law.
Esto es una ley espiritual, no solamente una ley natural, pero es una ley espiritual.
In Job, the fourth chapter, verse 8, it says, even if I have seen those who plow iniquity and sow trouble reap the same.
En el 4:8 dice, la experiencia me ha enseñado que los que siembran maldad van a cosechar desventura.
So again, this is a spiritual law.
Esto es una ley espiritual.
That also is applicable in the natural realm.
Que se aplica también en el área natural.
Now, the way that God is going to meet your needs,
de la manera que Dios va a suplir tu necesidad,
is through this principle of
a través
sowing
de este principio de sembrar y cosechar.
Go to Genesis, the 8th chapter, verse 22.
Vaya a Génesis 8:22.
See, the second law that God established on the earth is this.
La segunda ley que Dios establece es esta.
It's the law of seed time and harvest.
Es la ley de la siembra y la cosecha.
Look at Genesis 8:22. While the earth remains, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, winter and summer, and day and night shall not cease.
Mientras la tierra produzca, será establecida en la ley de siembra y de la cosecha.
It's seed time and harvest. Seed, time, and harvest.
Tiempo de siembra y tiempo de cosecha.
See, you sow the seed.
Tú siembra la semilla.
There's time.
Hay tiempo.
I mean, no, you don't sow tomatoes today.
¿Cuánto sabe que usted no siembra tomates hoy?
And eat tomatoes tomorrow.
Y se va a comer los tomates mañana.
There's time.
Hay un tiempo.
And then there's the harvest.
Y después viene la cosecha.
Okay, this is a principle.
Esto es un principio.
Matter of fact, in Mark the fourth chapter, I don't have time to read it now.
No tengo tiempo para leerlo ahora, pero en Marcos 4.
But Jesus taught on the parable of the sower.
Que Dios, Jesús habló de la parábola del sembrador.
And he said to the disciple who didn't understand the parable.
Él le dijo a los discípulos que no entendían la parábola.
If you don't understand this parable, how will you understand the other parables?
Si no entienden esta parábola, ¿cómo van a entender las otras?
And he went on to say in Mark the fourth chapter, around 26, 27, 28, that the kingdom of God works as if a man sows seed into the ground.
Y empezó a explicar que el reino de Dios en Marcos 4 del 20 y algo, que ese, así es el reino de Dios, como un hombre siembra una semilla.
In other words, this is the greatest principle that there is.
Este es el principio más grande
this
que hay.
This is the granddaddy of them all.
Este es el papá, el gran papá de la ley.
It's this principle that God used to reap a harvest of souls.
Este es el gran principio que Dios utiliza para sembrar y cosechar y recibir la cosecha.
No, this is a principle that God used to redeem mankind, to reap souls.
Oh, para redimir al hombre y traer almas.
Look at John the 12th chapter.
Mira el libro de Juan, el capítulo 12.
Look at verse 23.
Mira el verso ahí, 23.
Jesus answered them, saying, "The hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified." Verse 24. "Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces much grain." What was Jesus talking about? He was talking about his life being sown. Amen.
Él estaba hablando aquí de su vida que estaba siendo sembrada. Si el grano de trigo no cae en tierra,
you know,
y muere, se queda solo.
When you take a seed and you sow it, the seed dies.
Cuando usted siembra la semilla,
but it brings forth new life.
La semilla muere, pero trae vida nueva.
And Jesus said, "My life is going to be sown."
Él dijo, "Mi vida va a ser sembrada
in the ground,
en la tierra,
through my death,
a través de mi muerte.
I'm going to reap a harvest."
Yo voy a traer, voy a recoger una cosecha.
So I show you all of that because this is the greatest principle that there is.
Te enseño todo esto porque este es el principio más poderoso que hay.
And this is the principle that you and I need to learn to apply in our lives in order to have our needs met.
Y este es el principio que nosotros tenemos que aplicar en nuestra vida para que nuestras necesidades sean suplidas.
Look at Ephesians, the fourth chapter,
mira,
verse 28.
Efesios 4, 28.
The reason that you work,
la razón que tú trabajas,
is not for your needs to be met.
No es para que tus necesidades sean suplidas.
That's going to come as a shock to some of you.
Algunos de ustedes se van a sorprender de esto.
The reason that you work is so that you have seed to sow.
La razón que tú trabajes para que tú tengas semilla para poder sembrar.
Listen to me.
Escúcheme.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 4:4.
La Biblia dice en 1 Corintios 4:4.
That Satan is the god of this world.
Que Satanás es el rey, el dios de este siglo, perdón.
He's not the god of the earth. Jesus is Lord over the earth.
Él no es el dios de la tierra. Jesús es.
But he is the god of this world system.
Pero él es el dios de este siglo, del sistema de este mundo.
This world system is devised.
Este sistema de este mundo está dividido, devised o no está creado.
To keep you in poverty.
Te está creado para mantenerte
pobre.
Or to
keep you barely making it.
O mantenerte ahí raspando.
How many notice that your salary doesn't keep up with inflation?
¿Cuántos saben que tu salario no se mantiene conectado con la inflación que está ocurriendo?
They say, you know.
Ellos dicen
that there is approximately 2% of the people that control the money on this earth.
Que aproximadamente hay dos personas que controlan el dinero de este mundo completo. 2%.
Do you realize that there shouldn't be any poverty on earth?
¿Tú entiendes que no debe haber pobreza en el mundo?
Listen to me.
Escúchame.
There are approximately 7 billion people on earth right now.
Aproximadamente 7 billones en el mundo entero de la población.
Bill Gates alone is worth about $60 billion.
Nada más que Bill Gates tiene 60 billones.
That's just Bill Gates.
Ese es Bill Gates.
You know, if we took all these rich people,
si cogiéramos toda esta gente multimillonarios,
and you know, gave some of their money to people, there wouldn't be any poverty.
Y distribuyéramos el dinero de ellos, no hubiera pobreza.
Why is there poverty? Why are there people in the world today that are earning like in Africa, in China, some of these places, they're earning like $1 a day?
Porque hay personas en otras en terceras partes del mundo en otros lugares que se ganan $1 al día.
Because
salario.
Satan is the god of this world system.
Porque Satanás es el dios de este siglo, de este sistema.
So if you're trying to get your needs met through your job, you're going to be in trouble.
Si usted está tratando de suplir su necesidad a través de tu trabajo, estás en problemas.
And that's not the way God wants you to operate.
Y esa no es la manera que Dios quiere que tú operes.
But God wants you to come up here in the spiritual realm.
Dios quiere que tú te levantes en la dimensión espiritual, en la dimensión de fe,
where you operate in this principle of sowing and reaping.
Que donde tú operas en este principio de sembrar y cosechar.
Look at Ephesians 4:28.
Mira Efesios 4:28.
Notice what it says. It says, "Let him who stole steal no longer, but rather let him labor working with his hands what is good, that he may have something to give to him who has need."
Wow. El que robaba que no robaba nada, sino que trabaje honradamente con las manos para que tenga para compartir con los necesitados.
He says the reason that you work is because that is the way that I get seed into your hands.
La razón que tú trabajes para que tengas semilla en tu mano.
And then he expects for you to sow seed.
Y ahí él espera que entonces siembres esa semilla.
So your needs are met through your giving.
Así que tus necesidades son suplidas a través de tu dar.
Now see, you got to get your mind renewed to that because even though you're born again,
tú tienes que renovar tu mente porque aunque tú has nacido de nuevo,
you were programmed by the world's way of thinking.
Tú estabas programado por la manera del mundo de hacer las cosas. Hello.
See, so many people are programmed. You know, people are programmed from when they're young that in order to buy a car, you got to do it on credit.
Los niños, aún cuando son jovencitos, le enseñan que para poder
in order to buy a house, you got to do it on credit.
Que para comprar una casa tienes que ir al banco y coger prestado.
Hello.
Eso es lo que te enseña.
We got to get out of that mentality.
Esa es la mentalidad. Tenemos que salir de esa mentalidad.
You know, God can give you a house paid for.
Yo te puedo una casa que está paga.
He can give you a car paid for.
Un carro que está pago.
You know, but we got this mentality.
Pero tenemos esta mentalidad.
And it's going to take a while to get it out.
Y va a tomar un tiempo para
through
sacar
good
eso.
Teaching.
Para nos poder ser enseñados.
Now I guarantee you.
Yo te garantizo.
That the moment that I started preaching this.
Que el momento que yo empecé a predicar
the
esto.
The devil has already whispered in some of your ears.
El diablo ya le ha hablado a algunos cuantos de ustedes.
They're just after your money. That's all they want to do.
Él está buscando tu dinero,
they
tu
just
chavo.
Want a bigger offering,
eso es lo
know.
Que quieren. Quieren una buena ofrenda.
I picked that up already in my spirit. Some
ya
of you already are entertaining that junk.
Algunos de ustedes ya están pensando eso.
Huh?
Yo lo siento en mi espíritu.
You know, listen to me. I know that there are people out there that preach stuff with wrong motives.
Yo sé que hay pastores y personas que
predican
que predican el evangelio por las razones y motivos, las motivaciones erróneas.
And I detest people that do that.
Y yo detesto personas que hacen eso. Yo no hago eso.
And what I'm teaching you, I've been living for many years.
Y lo que yo te estoy enseñando, yo lo he vivido por muchos años.
And I've seen it work many times.
Y yo lo he visto trabajar muchas veces.
I pastored in Elizabeth, New Jersey, in the ghetto.
Yo pastoreaba en Elizabeth, New Jersey, donde era la gente más pobre.
I had people on welfare that got off of welfare.
Habían personas en welfare que se salieron.
I had a woman in my church one time had four kids.
Tenía una mujer que tenía cuatro hijos.
The guy that gave her the kids wasn't her husband.
El hombre que le dio los hijos no era su esposo.
And he was a deadbeat.
Y era un hombre terrible.
You know, in other words, he didn't do
no
the right thing monetarily.
No proveía para la
and
familia.
She had to collect welfare.
Y tenía ella que coger
and she used to tithe every month.
Y ella desmaba cada mes.
$400.
$400.
That's what she was getting from the government, $4,000 a month.
Ella recibía del gobierno 4,000 y le daba 400 a la iglesia.
I felt terrible receiving her tithe.
Y yo me sentía terrible recibiendo los diezmos de ella.
And the Lord said to me one day, if you don't receive her tithe, I can't bless her.
Si yo no recibe sus diezmos, yo no la puedo bendecir a ella.
So just in obedience to God, I still felt funny, you know, received the tithe from her.
En obediencia a Dios, aunque me sentía todavía raro, lo recibía los diezmos.
That woman got off welfare, got a job with Costco.
Esa mujer salió de welfare, empezó a trabajar en Costco.
And eventually got promoted and moved to Morristown, New Jersey, and bought a house.
Eventualmente se fue promovida y compró una casa y se movió a otro lugar.
And I had to help her find a church.
Y la ayudé a encontrar otra iglesia en su área.
That's just one of many testimonies. I can tell you people that didn't speak English, didn't have any education.
Te puedo dar muchos testimonios de personas que no hablaban inglés y no tenían educación. Y Dios los ayudó para que compraran su propia casa.
So I've proven this out in the 31 years that I've been serving God, and I know it works.
Yo he probado esto en los 30 años de servir al Señor.
So if you want to sit there and entertain the garbage of the devil, God bless you. Have a good day. Merry Christmas. Amen.
Si tú quieres entretener los pensamientos del diablo, Dios te bendiga y feliz Navidad.
So whatever, you know. It ain't going to affect me one bit.
No me va a afectar a mí.
Amen. So you do whatever you want to do.
A now, lo que tú quieras hacer.
Look at Luke 6:38.
Lucas 6:38.
And I've known your pastors for over 15 years, and I know they don't preach their stuff for money.
Y yo conozco a tus pastores por más de 15 años, ellos no predican por el dinero.
So. That's for sure. All right, Luke 6:38.
Lucas 6:38.
Notice what it says. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom.
Den y se les dará, se les echará en el regazo una medida llena, apretada, sacudida y desbordante.
For with the measure that you use, it will be measured back to you.
Porque con la medida que midan a otros, se les medirá a ustedes.
How you sow,
de la manera que tú siembras,
that's how it's going to come back to you.
Así va a venir donde ti.
You stingy?
¿Tú eres tacaño?
You know, you go to the restaurant and instead of giving them 50% tip, you give them sometimes nothing or 5%.
O tú le das a la persona que te sirve, en vez de darle el 15%, o le das el 5%, no le das nada.
Hello.
Hello.
See, how you sow is how you're going to reap.
Lo que tú siembras es lo que tú vas a cosechar.
You know, offering time comes and you reach it. You know, I used to say this in my church, and a guy eventually fessed up. I didn't know he was doing this. I just would say this.
You know, Cuando viene la ofrenda, haces esto. Hay una persona que yo dije esto, yo no sabía que lo estaba haciendo, pero lo estaba haciendo
en la iglesia. He later on told me, he's actually a pastor now. He got born in my ministry.
Él se convirtió en mi ministerio y es pastor ahora.
Before they come to church, they take all the small bills, the ones, you know, the singles, and put them in their left pocket.
Antes que venían a la iglesia, cogía los billetes de uno y los ponía.
All the big bills, put them in the right pocket.
Y ponían en la bolsillo
offering
izquierdo.
Offering time come, he reached in there get his dollar out of that left pocket.
Y los grandes en la mano derecha. Entonces cuando venía la ofrenda, venía a la mano izquierda con
and
los
the
pesitos.
Holy Ghost told on him, and he fessed up one day. He said, "That's me."
Y el Espíritu Santo lo expuso.
And then they squeeze that dollar so tight it makes George Washington cry, you know.
Y después con ese dólar y lo aprietan tanto que hacen que George Washington llore.
Who counts the offering here?
¿Quién cuenta la ofrenda aquí?
Who counts the offering?
Tenemos dos personas. We have two people. Carlos, levántate, levanta la mano.
Come on, look at him. Okay. Have you ever noticed that the singles are the ones that are crumbled up like that? Look like somebody was rolling a joint. Right? Am I right? You've never seen a $100 bill like that. Right?
Oh, Lordy. Okay. ¿Has visto esos pesitos que están envueltos como un cigarrillito? Ay, santo. Los de 100, como un tabaco, ajá. Los de 100 no los ves así, los ves bien abiertitos. Es los dólares que los ves así estrujados.
Listen to me, don't look at me in that tone of voice. Some of you smoked dope before you got saved, so come on.
No me miren así con esa cara rara, porque muchos de ustedes fumaron marihuana antes de venir al Señor. No sean santurrones.
What's she talking about?
Gloria a Dios que fuiste libre.
We're in church now, remember now, be honest.
Sean honestos, estamos en la iglesia.
I'm not talking about now. I'm talking about before you got saved.
No estoy hablando de ahora en el nombre del Señor.
You better not be smoking dope now.
Es mejor que no esté fumando marihuana ahora. Estoy hablando antes que viniste a Cristo.
You know, I realize that there are some people preaching some other kind of gospel where they're teaching people you can live your life any way that you want to because once saved, always saved.
Yo sé que no somos de los que están predicando que puedes vivir tu vida como quieras, salvo siempre salvo y puedes hacer lo que te dé la gana y todavía vas a ser salvo.
Practice sin, you ain't going to heaven. I'll tell you right now.
Tú practicas el pecado, no vas para el cielo.
So don't buy into that lie.
No te metas y no recibas esa mentira.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. So look at Matthew 7:12.
Ve a Mateo 7:12.
So you know, if you want to have your needs met, you have to operate in this principle.
Si tú quieres que tus necesidades sean suplidas, tú tienes que operar en este principio.
And
Mateo 7:12.
And God will tell you how to give two ways. One is through the Word of God.
Y Dios te va a enseñar a dar de dos maneras, a través de la palabra de Dios.
One is through the prompting of the Spirit.
Y otra es a través del Espíritu Santo decirte.
Now you know the Bible tells you that you in Malachi the third chapter that we are to bring all the tithe into the storehouse.
En Malaquías 3:10 te dice que traigas los diezmos y ofrendas al alfolí.
No, it says bring all the tithe into the
que traigan los diezmos al alfolí.
Right? It tells you in Malachi 3 that we ought to tithe and give offerings, but it says bring all the tithe into the storehouse.
Dice que traigan los diezmos al alfolí.
Tithe is 10%.
Las diezmos son el 10%.
If you're a member of this church, the first 10% of all your increase should be coming into this house.
Si tú eres miembro de esta iglesia, el 10% de todo lo que entre debe traerlo a la casa.
But you should be giving offerings too.
Pero también debes dar ofrendas.
Now, you determine offerings.
Tú determina la ofrenda.
Did you hear what I said? Because offerings are really your seed.
Porque la ofrenda es tu semilla.
Did you hear what I said? Tithing is not sowing.
El diezmo no es semilla.
Tithing is given to God what is His.
El diezmo es lo que le pertenece a Dios.
That's why in Hebrews 7, around verse 14, it says Abraham paid tithe to Melchizedek.
Por eso es que en Hebreo dice que Abraham le dio los diezmos a Melquisedec.
No, it says he paid.
Y le pagó los diezmos a Melquisedec.
Why?
Miren la palabra pagó.
Because that's due to God.
Porque eso se le debe a Dios.
In Leviticus 23:23.
En Levítico 23:23.
It says,
dice,
that under the law that if you use any part of the tithe, you owe God 20% interest.
Dice que si tú usas parte del diezmo, entonces le debes al Señor 20%.
Now I know that there's some people that are ignoramuses. that say this tithing is not, that was under the law, it's not for us in the New Testament.
Hay personas que son ignorantes y que están diciendo que el diezmo es de la ley y que ahora eso no aplica.
You better go back and read your Bible.
Es mejor que vayas atrás y leas tu Biblia.
And you start in Genesis, the fourth chapter, where Cain and Abel tithed and gave offerings.
En Génesis 4, donde Abel y Caín dieron su ofrenda.
Where did they learn that from? From Adam?
¿Dónde lo aprendieron de Adán?
Where did Adam learn it from? From God?
¿Dónde Adán lo aprendió de Dios?
So tithing didn't even start with Abraham.
Los diezmos no empezaron con Abraham.
Hello? And
Hello.
Abraham was tithing, and that was over 400 years before the law ever came.
Y Abraham ya estaba diezmando, y eso fue 400 años aún antes de la ley.
So, you know, these people that say that, they're just looking for an excuse not to give to God.
Esa persona que dicen eso es lo que estamos buscando, una excusa de no darle a Dios.
So here's what I have to say to you.
Esto es lo que tengo
para
decirte.
Stay broke.
Quédate pelado.
Stay broke.
Quédate pelado.
But I'm going to tell you something. When God starts transferring the wealth of the sinner into the righteous hands, and it ain't coming into your hands.
Pero cuando el Señor empieza a transferir las riquezas de los impíos a los justos, no te va a llegar donde ti.
If you're not tithing, giving offerings to God, God says you're robbing him.
Porque si tú no estás dando diezmos y ofrendas, le estás robando a Dios.
Do you realize that you don't own anything?
¿Tú entiendes que tú no, nada es tuyo?
It's not your car, it's not your house, not even your money.
No es tu carro, no es tu casa.
Psalm 24, verse 1 says, "The earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell in it."
Salmo 24 dice que toda la tierra es del Señor y todo lo que está en ella también.
Haggai, the second chapter says, "The silver and the gold is mine."
Y también dice que el oro y la plata es mía, dice el Señor.
En Haggai, capítulo 2.
En Ageo.
Ageo, yeah. Mm-hmm. Ageo.
Ageo 2.
That was Spanglish, you know.
I know.
Haggai. A little Puerto Rican came out of me, you know what I'm saying? You know, I was born in Cuba, you know, but I came to the United States when I was 8.
Yo nací en Cuba y vine a los Estados Unidos cuando tenía 8.
And I go to Latin America to preach, and they go to me and say, very, very politely, they're very reverential, you know. They go, con permiso, pastor, ¿usted cubano o puertorriqueño?
¿Usted qué?
¿Cubano o puertorriqueño?
Oh, en Centroamérica le preguntaban bien calladitos, ¿usted es cubano o es puertorriqueño?
I said, I was born in Cuba, but I grew up with the Puerto Ricans in New York, you know.
Yo nací en Cuba, pero me crié con los puertorriqueños en Nueva York, y me influenciaron los puertorros.
So I like black beans.
Me gustan las habichuelas negras.
Pero las habichuelas rojas están buenas también.
But the red beans, they're good too.
Y gandules, you know.
Y los gandulitos, con arroz con gandules.
Getting hungry already, man.
That sister
cooked us a mean meal right there.
Ya me está dando hambre esta hermana.
Bless her, man.
Dios
she's anointed.
Está ungida, tiene unas manos para esa comida.
You should open up a restaurant and have her running, man. Make some money.
Debe abrir un restaurante y dejarlo que ella lo corra. Va a ser chavo, dinero.
Hallelujah. Did you find Matthew 7:12?
Va a encontrarte Mateo 7:12.
If you didn't find it by now, you're not going to find it today. So
si no lo encontraste ya, no lo vas a encontrar.
Therefore, whatever you want men to do to you, you also do them. This is the law and the prophets.
Esta, así que en todo traten a ustedes los demás tal y como quieren que sean tratados.
What you sow is what you reap.
Esto es un principio.
You want to be given, learn to give. Amen.
Si quieres que te den, aprende a dar.
Not only pay your tithe, but learn to follow the leading of the Spirit.
No solamente los diezmos, pero aprende a escuchar la voz del Espíritu Santo.
God meets people needs through people.
Dios necesita.
No, God meets people's needs through people.
Dios provee las necesidades de las personas a través de las personas.
God doesn't rain money from heaven. I wish he did.
Dios no envía dinero del cielo.
Hello?
Que caiga del cielo como lluvia.
You probably get more support that way for the ministry.
A lo mejor recibimos más apoyo si fuera así del ministerio.
But you know, God meets the needs of people through people.
Dios provee las necesidades de las personas a través de las personas.
So if a person is believing God for something,
si la persona está creyendo a Dios por algo,
you may be the one that God wants to use to supply that need.
Dios a lo mejor te quiere usar a ti para suplir la necesidad de ese hermano.
And what is he going to do?
¿Qué es lo que él va a hacer?
He's going to put it in your heart to do it.
Él lo va a poner en tu corazón para que lo hagas.
Hello.
Hello.
See, listen to me. Do not allow yourself to be manipulated.
No permitas ser manipulado.
Concerning giving money.
Concerniente a dar dinero.
I can't stand when I see some of these ding-dongs on television.
Yo no soporto algunas de estas personas en televisión.
Prophesying to people.
Que están mintiendo en la televisión.
See, the Lord showed me that there are 10 people that can give $5,000 into this ministry.
El Señor me ha enseñado que hay 10 personas que pueden dar 5,000 dinero a este ministerio.
And they spend 15-20 minutes doing that.
Y pasan 15-20 minutos haciendo eso.
I've seen them do that in services.
Yo he visto eso aún en servicios.
And play that song for 15, 20, 25 minutes until five dummies get up and give $5,000.
y pasan haciendo eso 20, 25 minutos hasta que cinco personas vienen al frente.
That is manipulation.
Eso es manipulación.
And you're not going to be blessed doing that.
Y tú no vas a ser bendecido haciendo eso.
Like
o darlo a un ministerio de esa manera.
What I'm talking about it, listen to me. You don't have to have somebody prophesy to you to do something.
Tú no necesitas que alguien te profetice para que hagas algo.
The Bible says in Romans 8:14, they that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God.
La Biblia dice en Juan que aquellos que son
Romans 8:14.
Que aquellos que son del Espíritu de Dios son guiados por el Espíritu Santo.
They that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God.
Los guiados del Espíritu Santo son hijos de Dios.
So you should be being led by the Spirit.
Tú tienes que dejarte guiar por el Espíritu Santo.
And the Holy Spirit will impress you.
Y el Espíritu Santo te va a decir.
You understand? To give to a ministry, to give to an individual, to
a dar un ministerio a un individuo, él te va a dirigir.
And if you will learn to listen to him and obey him when he tells you.
Si tú lo aprendieras a escuchar y obedecerlo cuando él te lo dice.
Hello. Then God can trust you with money.
Entonces Dios puede confiar dinero en ti, en tus manos.
And he's going to increase what you have.
Y él va a aumentar lo que tú tienes.
So that your own life can benefit, but that you can continue to sow bountifully.
Y para que tu vida sea bendecida y tú puedas bendecir a otros abundantemente.
Because the reason for prosperity is so that you can be a blessing.
Porque la razón para prosperar es para que tú seas una bendición a otros.
You know, God told Abraham in Genesis 12, he said, I'm going to bless you that you can be a blessing.
Dios le dijo a Abraham en Génesis 12, yo te voy a bendecir para que bendigas.
You can't be a blessing when you're broke.
Tú no puedes bendecir si tú no tienes nada.
You know, when you're broken, you can't pay your bills, you're stressed out.
Cuando tú no tienes para pagar tus cuentas, te has estresado.
You know, you probably got family problems.
Y problemas familiares también.
Because, you know, financial lack causes problems in the marriage.
Problemas financieros causan problemas en el matrimonio.
Yeah. Eso es. Mm-hmm. It causes problems with your kids when you can't buy them things for Christmas or things that they need.
Te causa problemas con tus hijos que no les puedes comprar las cosas que ellos quieren para la Navidad o las cosas que necesitan.
Amen. All right, so go over to 2 Corinthians, ninth chapter. 2 Corinthians, the ninth chapter.
Segunda de Corintios, capítulo 9.
And see, let me tell you something. It's God's money. It's not yours.
Es el dinero de Dios, no es tuyo.
He supplies it to you.
Él te lo suple a ti.
He tells you to sow it.
Él te dice que lo siembres.
Through the word and by the Spirit.
A través de la palabra y a través del Espíritu Santo.
In good ground.
En buen terreno.
And then he will multiply what you've given him.
Y después va a multiplicar lo que tú le has dado.
That's a pretty good deal.
Ese negocio está muy bueno.
And listen to me. Escúchame. It works every time.
Trabaja todo el tiempo.
It's a spiritual law.
Es una ley espiritual.
It works. It's like gravity.
Es como la ley de gravedad.
Hello.
Hello.
You climb up on the roof today.
Tú te trepas en el techo
jump
hoy.
Off,
te brincas.
You're going to splatter.
Vas a caer como
particularly if you go head first.
Esparrachao. Más si te vas de cabeza primero.
You come next week.
Viene la próxima semana.
Do it again.
Lo hace otra vez.
If you survive the first time.
Si sobrevive la primera.
And it's going to happen again.
Y va a ocurrir lo mismo
why?
Si lo haces otra vez.
Gravity is a law.
La gravedad es una ley.
It doesn't take days off.
Y no toma
it
tiempo,
works all the time.
No toma tiempo libre, trabaja todo
so
el tiempo.
Does this law.
Así es esta
but
ley.
But you got to work it in faith.
Pero tú tienes que trabajarla en fe.
You got to work it in faith.
Y tienes que hacerlo en fe.
And that's why I'm teaching you by the direction of the Holy Spirit to get faith into you.
Por eso que te estoy enseñándote a través del Espíritu Santo para poner fe en ti.
And then if you have been unfaithful in these areas, that you repent and get it together and start operating in these principles so God can increase you.
Y si tú has sido infiel en estas áreas, empieza a hacer las cosas correctas para
listen
que Dios te puede dar aumentar.
We need some prosperous people in the body of Christ so we can get this gospel preached.
Necesitamos gente próspera en el cuerpo de Cristo para predicar este evangelio.
Hello.
Hello. Eso es así.
You know, we need some people that can write some checks of $50,000, $100,000, $1 million.
Necesito personas que puedan escribir un cheque de 50,000, 100,000, 1,000,000.
Takes a long time to, you know, get $1 million by receiving dollars and $5 in the offering, don't it?
Toma un tiempo largo de recoger un millón si lo haces poquito a poco.
But we need the money to preach the gospel.
Necesitamos el dinero para predicar este evangelio.
Once this gospel is preached throughout the world,
una vez que este evangelio sea predicado a través del mundo,
hello,
se acabó.
It's over.
Se acabó.
We go home.
Nos vamos para casa.
Hello.
Hallelujah.
I don't know about you, but you know, I'm looking forward to getting a glorified body.
Yo no sé tú, pero yo quiero un cuerpo glorificado. Aleluya.
I'm looking forward to getting all my hair back.
Yo quiero mi pelo para atrás.
Hello. I'm looking forward to weighing 155 pounds again with six-pack abs like I had when I was in my 20s in the military.
Yo quiero pesar 155 y tener los six-pack.
Thank you. God bless you, sister.
Gracias, hermana. Gracias, hermana.
Sister back there said, "You don't look bad now, bro." God bless you.
Dios la bendiga, hermanita.
I read lips.
Que no me veo mal. Yo leo los labios.
You stand up here and you see people's faces. You see some of the faces, man. Some people go, "Where'd the pastor get this guy from, man?"
Yo veo la carita. ¿De dónde el pastor sacó este hermano?
I tell you what your problem is. You've been taking too many religious pills.
Tú has tomado muchas píldoras religiosas.
You got a misconception about God.
Tienes un concepto erróneo de Dios.
I tell you, God is cool.
Dios
He's cool. He's up to date. He's hip.
Él está al día. Él es cool.
God's not some old guy in heaven with a beard, you know, sitting on the throne with a fly swatter looking to smack you upside the head.
Él no es un viejo con barba y está esperando con un látigo a ver qué se hace mal para.
So how do you know people think that? Because I used to think like that. I was raised up in the Catholic Church. You know, I was scared that God was going to, you know, kill me.
Yo, y como yo sé que tú piensas así, porque yo pensaba así, yo me crié católico.
Amen, because they taught me this ungodly fear, you know, God's going to get you if you do something wrong.
Y creía que Dios me quería matar.
I go to school, you know, I was just a young boy going to school, elementary school over in Brooklyn, and I walked by the Catholic Church and forgot to do the sign of the cross, and I go, oh my, I get scared, you know.
O fue a la iglesia católica y se me olvidó y creía que me iba a pasar, me iba a morir.
So I go around the block and go past the church again and do the sign, you know, make sure I was cool. That's not the God we serve, amen. That's another God.
Ese no es el Dios que servimos. Dios es un Dios bueno.
God is cool.
Dios es bueno.
He got a sense of humor.
Y él es cómico también.
Hello, he's got a good sense of humor. If you don't believe me, look at some of the people he's created.
Él tiene un buen sentido del humor. Mira cuántas te creó, nos creó a nosotros.
Oh, Jesus.
Ríete, Cristo te ama.
I don't know about you. I'm glad I came to church, you know.
Estoy contento que vine a la iglesia.
2 Corinthians 9, verse 6.
2 de Corintios 9, verso 6.
This I say.
Recuerden esto.
He who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly.
El que siembra escasamente, escasamente cosechará.
He who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully.
Y el que siembra en abundancia.
Now, for time's sake, I didn't read chapter 8, but if you read it, you'll find that Paul is receiving an offering.
Y si lo quieres leer completo, Pablo estaba recogiendo una ofrenda.
And notice he talks about money as being seed.
Y mire que él ve el dinero como una semilla.
And he says, if you want to reap bountifully, you got to sow bountifully.
Y mire lo que dice, si siembra en abundancia, va a cosechar en abundancia. Verso 7.
So let each one give as he has purpose in his heart.
Cada uno debe según haya decidido en su corazón.
See, everything we do it from the heart or from your spirit. That's what the heart is talking about here, is your spirit.
Todo lo hacemos de nuestro corazón o de nuestro espíritu, ese es el corazón.
Because we're doing it in faith.
Porque lo hacemos en fe.
And faith is of the heart, of
the
spirit. Y
fe viene del corazón, del espíritu.
Amen. Faith is not from the head, it's from the heart, from in here.
La fe no viene de la cabeza, viene del corazón, del espíritu.
All right, now, it says, let each one give us his purpose in his heart, verse 7, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver.
Cada uno de como propuso en su corazón, no con tristeza ni por necesidad, porque Dios ama al dador alegre.
Now notice, not grudgingly. Oh, I got to give in the offering again.
No con tristeza.
When I pastored, I said to people, if that's your attitude in giving, you might as well not give. Go get your heart right, because God's not going to bless that.
No por obligación. Si tú lo haces de esa manera, mejor no lo des.
And we don't give out of necessity. We don't give, you know, these preachers that get on television or on radio, and they go, well, you know, if you all don't give, we're going to have to close the door, you know, on the mission. And let them close the door.
No es por necesidad.
Let them close the door.
Esta persona que te piden porque van a
God doesn't want you to give to begging preachers.
Dios no quiere que tú le estés dando a predicadores que están mendigando.
And we don't give, listen to me, we don't give simply because there's a need.
No damos simplemente porque hay una necesidad.
Let me say that again. We don't give just simply because there's a need. We give by the direction of the Word and the Holy Spirit.
No damos porque hay una necesidad. Damos por la dirección del Espíritu Santo o por la palabra.
We can go out here in Dover, Delaware, and find a lot of people with needs.
Podemos salir y ver mucha necesidad.
But sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes some of the people got needs, so they don't want to work.
Y algunas personas tienen esa necesidad, no todos.
Or they do
porque no trabajan, no quieren trabajar.
Or they do foolish things with their money.
O hacen cosas tontas con su dinero.
Hello. Mm-hmm. That's one of the problems that we have right now in the housing market.
Eso es uno de los problemas que tenemos ahora en las finanzas.
People bought houses they couldn't afford.
Compraron casas que no podían y que no tenían el dinero.
Because the companies made it easy for them to borrow. They did away with a lot of the common sense rules that they had.
Porque las compañías lo hicieron fácil para poder coger el dinero prestado.
Hello. So, you know, we don't give out of necessity. We give because God is leading us to give.
No lo damos por necesidad, sino porque Dios nos ha dirigido a dar.
All right. So, and God loves a cheerful giver.
Y Dios ama al dador alegre.
Now, some people think that says tearful.
Algunos piensan que es el dador que está llorando.
But that says cheerful.
Ahí dice alegre.
Amen. All right. So, look at verse 8. And God is able to make all grace.
Y Dios puede hacer que toda gracia
abound toward you.
Abunde para ustedes.
So God,
así que Dios,
causes first of all,
hace primeramente,
for grace to come back to you.
Que gracia abunde para ti.
Grace is God's favor.
Gracia es el favor de Dios.
See, when you have a giving spirit,
cuando tú tienes un espíritu que da,
and this is a way of life with you,
y esa es la vida que tú vives,
God is not only going to multiply your seed sown, but he's going to cause favor to come on you.
Dios no solamente va a multiplicar tu semilla, pero el favor de Dios va a estar sobre ti.
You remember Cornelius?
¿Tú sabes Cornelio?
Acts the 10th chapter.
Hechos, el capítulo 10.
He wasn't even born again.
Él no era ni cristiano, era pagano.
But the Bible says he feared God.
Pero la Biblia dice que él tenía temor a Jehová.
Prayed always.
Él oraba siempre.
And gave much alms.
Y daba sus limosnas.
It says much alms.
Muchas limosnas.
Yeah. He's so bountiful. You know what? God sent an angel.
¿Sabes qué? Dios le envió un ángel.
And says, Cornelius,
le dijo, Cornelio,
your alms,
tus limosnas,
and your prayers,
y tus oraciones,
have made a memorial before God.
Han hecho un memorial en el cielo.
You know what a memorial is?
¿Tú sabes lo que es un memorial?
It's a monument that they we have the World War II monument, we have the
monumento de la Segunda Guerra Mundial,
the Vietnam Memorial.
El monumento de la
now,
guerra de Vietnam.
I think they have a memorial now for 9/11 victims.
Ahora para 9/11 las víctimas.
What is that? So people remember.
Esto es para que las personas recuerden, amen, se acuerden.
You know, when you have a lifestyle of being devoted to God,
cuando tú tienes una vida que está dedicada al Señor,
prayer,
y tú eres una persona
and you're
de oración,
a giver, you're making a memorial before God.
Y tú das ofrendas al Señor, el Señor va a hacer un memorial de ti.
And when God, it was time for the Gentiles to come into the kingdom of God, God sent an angel to tell him to go get Peter to come and preach the gospel to him.
Y cuando era tiempo que los gentiles vinieran al conocimiento del evangelio, Dios envió un ángel que le dijera a Pedro que le viniera a predicar a Cornelio y su familia.
And he gathered all his friends and all his family and his house and waited.
Y Cornelio trajo toda su familia y sus amigos y esperó.
And God wanted so much to bless that man that he didn't let Peter finish his message.
Y Dios quería bendecir a ese hombre tanto que no permitió ni que Pedro terminara el mensaje.
It says, Acts 10:44, while Peter yet spoke, the Holy Ghost fell.
Hechos 10:44 dice que mientras Pedro hablaba, el Espíritu descendió.
They got saved.
Fueron salvos.
Filled with the Holy Spirit.
Llenos del Espíritu Santo.
Speaking in tongues.
Hablaron en lenguas.
Just like in the day of Pentecost.
Como el día de Pentecostés.
All in one shot.
Todo de un cantazo.
Why? The grace of God.
Por la gracia de Dios.
There's another story, 2 Kings, the 4th chapter.
Hay otra historia en Segunda de Reyes, capítulo 4.
There was a Shunammite woman.
Hay una mujer sunamita.
She was married to a very wealthy older guy.
Ella estaba casada con un hombre mayor, pero que tenía mucho dinero.